Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to Show It Better. My name is Steven. And in today's video, we're going to play around with the orthographic effect in Lumion 11. Specifically, we're going to see how we went from this concept diagram all the way to this final diagram made in Lumion. This video is going to be divided into three steps. The first one is this concept idea sketching phase. The second step is the modeling phase in SketchUp. And the third phase is the work that we're going to do in Lumion. So without further ado, let's start. Before we start, I just have two announcements. So I want to thank Skillshare for sponsoring this video. The first 1,000 people to click the link in the description will get a free trial of premium membership. And second, I want to thank all of our Patreons for supporting this channel and making it sustainable for us each week. If you want to have access to the long form videos and to the project files of each tutorial that we release here on YouTube, then join our Patreon community and get access to all the files. Now, let's jump into the tutorial. So I started my project by creating three different types of street profiles that I wanted to achieve in the final image. I used for reference the different types of street profiles that you can find in different kinds of cities around the world, where you maybe have some predominance in car lanes or some predominance in bike paths or pedestrian paths. These drawings were done in Photoshop and they were also done with my graphic display tablet. At first, it was a little tricky to get all these straight lines according to the same angle, the same isometric angle that I wanted them to go on. So that's why later on I overlaid an isometric grid on top of it and put it to 10 or 20%. So I could barely see it, but I could understand where the lines, where the major lines and angles were going to go through. To these drawings, I also tried to add the most detail as possible, like textures, people, the size of trees relative to the diagram, and also the depth of each image. As you guys can see, in the final sketch, we have three different types of drawings with their annotations on their spaces. After having done this, I proceeded to open my SketchUp model so I could start creating these diagrams that I had done in Photoshop. And I wanted to create them not in a very precise way because I knew these were just reference diagrams. Maybe if you are creating a project that has very specific urban profiles, very specific street profiles, you might want to be much more specific on this step. What I also wanted to create was a type of diagram where we had some mountains, some, you know, undulating paths, undulating green areas, and that is why I used the sandbox tool in SketchUp. Because I know that you can also do this in Lumion, but it is not that very specific, and I'm not really a fan of creating terrains on Lumion because of the specificity or maybe the lack of specificity. I also wanted to start by applying materials here on each of the diagrams, so when I jumped onto Lumion, all the materials were already applied. And I just had to modify them, or maybe, you know, modify or tweak just a little bit part of them. The final diagram was maybe the most interesting one because it had a bridge, a pedestrian path bridge that went on top and, you know, hovered over all the natural area. And also there was a bike lane on the bottom. I wanted to add a little bit of interest to the columns of that bridge, so I made them in a more Brazilian kind of style. And I also proceeded to add some materials and some verandas that could also add a lot of detail to the image. After having done this SketchUp modeling step, I proceeded to open my Lumion 11 and also activate my live sync option. Here, it is very important that when you're creating your project template, you choose the create a design showcase template. The good thing about this is that it already has a white ground and a white sky, which is one of the key elements to get that diagrammatic look that we want from a program like Lumion. After having done this, the SketchUp model was imported and I started creating the basic materials, which weren't that much to be honest, which was only the grass, the bike lane, the pedestrian path, and some concrete here and there. After having done this as well, I proceeded to open my camera settings and activate the orthographic effect on Lumion. This is probably the most important thing about this video, that you have to have this orthographic effect on. But in case you don't have Lumion 11 and you have Lumion 10 or a version that is before Lumion 10, then you can also kind of simulate this by changing your field of view or changing the angle in your field of view to the one that gets closer to 0 degrees. It doesn't quite get a technical orthographic mode, but it gets very close, so you could kind of replicate that. I started adding vegetation to each of the diagrams. I chose the fine detail vegetation because I knew that I was going to take out specific images that were going to be in very high resolution, and I was also going to create a video on each of the diagrams, and I knew that I wanted to have very nice vegetation. Maybe I could have done a much better job with the vegetation. I could have made it a little bit more site specific. So if you have a very specific site, maybe, I don't know, in a certain place in South America or in a specific city, then the vegetation is going to be very specific to that geography. I also changed the texture of the road because, well, honestly, this is something Lumion is lacking, which is, you know, some real textures or some different options for textures, for road textures. So I imported textures that I had downloaded from textures.com, and I resized it and oriented it correctly or accordingly to each of the car lanes. Adding to this, I modified each of the materials by adding a little bit of aging to each of the materials. This is a very nice detail when you want to have some non-perfect materials, and you also want to maybe smooth the edges out because some of these edges can be very rugged, very harsh, and the eye, the human eye, can see those kind of things. I also added a car, which I think wasn't the best car. I'm not sure if Lumion has very good cars to the moment, but it was the one that I found the best, that I found suited the best to for this image. I added some street lamps, some benches, some people that were walking on the path, some dumpsters on the street, and also added people that were using very specifically each kind of path that we wanted to show. So if it was in a park, a kid there, if it was in a bike lane, I also put a person riding a bike. Finally, I added the reflections. I adjusted the reflections because I had some glass verandas, and I also had streets with a little bit of reflection and concrete on them as well. The final step here was to adjust the angle, the pitch, and the orientation of the orthographic projection. Now, obviously, you could do this as Lumion says, or with Lumion settings, since I already had a projection angle defined in my Photoshop sketch. Then what I did was activate the image overlay effect on Lumion. I overlaid the sketch on top of it, and I tweaked the parameters of pitch, of orientation, and heading until it almost matched exactly to the drawing that I had made. This way it was much easier to do a before and after kind of style of image, and it was also easier to know what angle it was oriented in, since I know that the isometric grid that I overlaid in the Photoshop sketch was an exact 45 to 45 degree angle. Then I knew that this orthographic projection was going to be in that angle as well. Having that said, if you want to create orthographic projections with a specific angle, then what I suggest you do is first Google the orthographic grid that you would want. So maybe isometric grid or 30 degree grid, 30, 20, etc., etc. Then you can overlay it with the image overlay effect on top of your photo, on top of your Lumion image, and then you would know that it could be a very technical and exact kind of drawing. That is what is going to make it much more diagrammatic, and it's going to give it that diagrammatic and exact feel. And finally, we hit the render button. I sometimes export my normals and my render ID just because I want to see the end result, but not because I'm going to use them. And I imported my image into Photoshop and tried to overlay the sketches that I had done in the beginning and tried to compare the before and the after. What I also did was I added a color balance adjustment layer because everything was looking very, very bluish. So I wanted to look a little bit more warm into the warm side. And finally, I went back to Lumion and I animated just a bit everything that we had done, the birds, the people, all the colors that we had put in, and I imported this animation into After Effects, and I animated just a little bit of text to make it look much more interesting and to maybe erase that Lumion feel that you would get from the beginning. Okay, so this was the final result of our image. At the end, I decided to animate it, but it wasn't that complex. It was just the basic animations that you can do in Lumion. This just gives me a lot of ideas for the future for using orthographic mode and the rendering style of Lumion. I think it can be done in a much, much better way. It can be adjusted in a much better way. I know that many of you don't like Lumion because of its Lumion effects, but I tried to get that out of the way in the best way possible. And I think it can be done much, much better. And yeah, I really like the final result. And I wanna thank you guys, and I also wanna thank our sponsors, because without them, this channel couldn't survive as it survives. We couldn't upload videos every week and do all the things that we do on Instagram as well. So I wanna thank Skillshare for sponsoring this video. So Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of inspiring classes for creative and curious people. So you can learn literally anything that you want in Skillshare, from animation, graphic design, productivity hacks, Photoshop, animation for your architectural projects, etc. You can learn all of this in Skillshare. And it is curated specifically for learning, meaning that there are no ads and they're always launching new premium classes. So you can stay focused and follow wherever your creativity takes you. And it is less than $10 a month with an annual subscription. So one class I recommend taking is 3D Illustration, Creating Isometric Designs in Adobe Illustrator by DKNG Studios. They have a pretty nice set of lessons, and this one does not disappoint. And you can even see in the students' work that they produce that it has some really nice outputs, and it's very, very related to architecture. So if you are interested, I recommend taking this class with Skillshare. So the first 1,000 of my subscribers to click the link in the description will get a free trial of a Skillshare membership so you can explore your creativity. So I don't know if all of you guys made it to the end of this video. If you did, thank you. And according to YouTube Analytics, more than 52% of the people that watch Show It Better haven't subscribed yet. So if you haven't subscribed yet, click the red button down below, subscribe, and like this video. If you also want to get notifications every time we upload, which is every week, then turn on the notification bell. And that is it. That is it. I honestly like to talk at the end because I know that there are very, very few people that stay till the end, and just chill a bit. And I've been meaning to make this orthographic Lumion video for a while, since Lumion 11 came out, but there were so many Lumion 11 videos that I didn't want to just create another video because it was just Lumion 11. So I waited a bit and wanted to see what I could do with the orthographic mode, if I could do just some plain diagrams that you would normally do with V-Ray and with SketchUp. So, you know, effectively you can do really nice diagrams, but I would honestly suggest to try to take that Lumion effect out as much as possible. And how do you do that? First of all, you don't use the Lumion styles that you get by default. So the overcast, the rendering, like the realistic style, the day style, don't use these. Just use your own style and do a lot of post-production on Photoshop as well, or a lot of color correction, so it has a different feel to it, so it has a different tint to it. And that is it, guys. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you in a next video. Bye. So I don't know if you guys remember this little guy right here. Oh, he's stretching out.